1.2, who's the greatest? How much I miss my grandma's tales. When I was very young, every night my grandma used to narrate me stories of fairies, knights, demons, kings and princes. As I grew a little older, reading stories became my favorite pastime. Those days, I enjoyed reading Aesop's fables, children's fiction, and Akbar Birbal stories too. Emperor Akbar, or Akbar the Great, is known as one of the greatest rulers in the world, not just because he had a vast empire, a very strong army, untold wealth, but because he was a good human being. He cared for his subjects. He had great respect for scholars, writers, poets, and artists belonging to different religions. He was a patron of art and culture, meaning a person who appreciated, supported, and encouraged art and culture. The 9 gems or Navratnas in his court were famous. Many people believe that of these 9 gems, Birbal was the closest to the emperor's heart. Akbar loved to pose, meaning ask interesting questions or problems in his court. And Birbal never failed to come up with an equally interesting answer. We don't know whether all the Akbar and Birbal stories that we hear today have any basis in history. They have been handed down over generations, mainly by word of mouth. Here are 2 of them. One day, the emperor entered the court with a very serious expression on his face. As soon as he was seated, he said that he had a question for all the people present in the court. He further added that what should be the punishment for someone who pulls his mustache? The court was stunned, meaning shocked. Pull the emperor's mustache? It was unheard of. One nobleman exclaimed that he should be flogged, meaning beaten hard, given 50 lashes of the whip. Another added, that's not enough. He should be put in jail without food and water. Slowly, the agitated, meaning disturbed courtiers began to cry out, whip him, beat him, hang him, cut off his offending hands. Only Birbal was silent. He was even smiling a little. On seeing Birbal silent and smiling, Akbar asked him what he had to say and what was his opinion. Birbal replied that in his opinion, O giver of peace to the world, the offender should be given his favorite sweetmeats. On hearing Birbal's reply, the agitated courtiers asked Birbal if he was out of his mind. How could he suggest to give sweetmeats for such a grave, meaning serious offense, meaning crime? In reply to the posed question, Birbal smiled and explained, who would be so bold as to pull the emperor's mustache? Only his own grandson. When Akbar heard this, he burst out laughing because that was exactly what had happened that morning. On another occasion, Akbar was relaxing with some of his courtiers. A few of them thought it was a good opportunity to shower praise on the emperor and get some favors from him. They began to compete with each other in praising Akbar. One of the courtiers said, you are the greatest of the kings. Another added, you are the greatest of the kings or emperors that ever lived on the earth. Third courtier further said, you are the greatest of all the people in heaven or earth. Another courtier said, you are as great as God Almighty. Another courtier further added, you're greater than the God Almighty. Now Akbar was no fool. He did not care for false praise. He stopped the courtiers and asked them if they all believed so. Yes, they answered in one voice. On hearing the unanimous reply, Akbar told them to prove it to him. He asked them to tell him at least one thing that he could do but God Almighty would not be able to do. He further warned them that if they failed to prove it, they all would incur his royal displeasure, meaning experience his anger. He further intimated them that they had been given time till the next day's morning to prove it. Akbar then left the place without another look at the courtiers. They were in a proper fix, meaning difficult situation. They thought and thought, but couldn't think of any such thing. In the end, they went to Birbal. When Birbal heard their story, he told them not to worry. The next morning, the court was full. Everyone was curious to see what would happen next. The emperor asked the courtiers if they had found a good answer to his question. He further added that if not, were they ready to leave the court forever? Just then, Birbal stepped forward and bowed low. He pleaded the emperor not to be angry with those who think he was the greatest. He further said that there was certainly at least one thing that he could do, but the God Almighty couldn't. Akbar looked at Birbal thoughtfully and inquired what was that one thing. Birbal told Akbar that whenever he wished to punish someone, he could banish that person, throw him out of his kingdom. But God's kingdom extends everywhere. The Almighty cannot banish anyone from his kingdom. Akbar's face was lit up with a smile. He was happy to hear Birbal's reply. He appreciated Birbal for his clever reply. He further added that while showing the king that he had an advantage, he also showed that God is greater. Akbar told Birbal that he believed him. Akbar was so pleased with the answer that he forgave the courtiers for their stupidity.